Yeah, welcome to the exhibition of Herbert W. Franke, Visionary. He's a pioneer in many fields, and we dedicated an exhibition on the occasion of his 95th birthday, and due to honoring a cultural decoration of Upper Austria given to him. The exhibition was curated by Susanne Pech, the wife and a media journalist and specialist who is also responsible for the archive of Herbert W. Franke. We created, for example, a list of pioneering achievements. So he was very active till his very late, till the last years, and he continued to work also with computers and with programs. And very special is that he used to work always with the space in time-based media. So what we can see as computer graphics are always kind of screenshots of a development or part of a bigger series. Herbert W. Franke is studied in Austria, in Vienna, in his hometown, physics, chemistry, psychology, philosophy, and so he was kind of part of the Viennese school, thinking about a broader way of how science and is connected with other phenomena of the world. The very first room is dedicated to the early 50s and to the mathematics principle of continuity in nature and in art. What we see here is an image of Herbert W. Franke in the Dachstein Mountain, so in the caves, and kind of his work really started in the caves of the Dachstein. So he started to publish the explorations he did, and also he invented a kind of a method to really show these huge caves in this early stage. Kind of to work with flash was based on magnesium light, and he did serial flashes to really enlight the entire cave. Here we kind of have this system, which is a quote of his very first exhibitions held in the Mack Museum, but also then went to Zurich and London. And what we show here is his generative photography. So he used different kind of machines or apparatus to generate images. For example, we have here, what you can see is an oscillograph. So this is a machine to show electricity waves. And he used this to generate images. And what we can see here and here are images done with these oscillographs. So, or what he did is to work also with strings. So to kind of keep the movement as in a still image, done with a Röntgen apparat. And the mathematical principles you can find in nature, for example here, in the way how these Tropfsteine, how they grow, and also, for example, in this way, in this work here, where he drilled a plastic form and then left it, and the way it moves is also in this mathematical principle of continuity. For natural science, one of his big achievements was to really to work with the C14 method to make clear how old these caves are. So this room is dedicated to the principle of Fibonacci, dragon curves, rotations, like this video behind. And what you see here are his early works done with computers, but not with the personal computer, but with this really the big computers which used several spaces to work. And he programmed, for example, this here in with the system of Dracula, and the program always decides left or right, yes or no. And it's very important also for his way of working that he understood that the computer or the machine is always a partner. That's why also in his entire body of work, so these 65 years of algorithmic or mathematic based art, always looks different. Okay. The video piece behind me is an animation he did for the Bayerische Staatsbühne, and it was generated with a computer and then filmed and used as kind of one player together with one dancer and with laser light for a performance piece. And it's really 1974, it's one of the earliest computer-generated videos. Herbert W. Franke always connected also time-based media with sound. So this was an important impact, and he used to also play in a jazz band, improvising. Here we have two works, the Quadrate, so the Quadrates, it's also based on a program. It's one of his core works, and it is now also an NFT. So it's a good example how Herbert W. Franke always continued to go with the time. For example, for this exhibition, we started in the preparations in March. He started a Twitter account and became and had, after 3 days, already 10,000 followers. So he is acknowledged as a media art pioneer, and there is a lot of response and feedbacks, especially from a younger media art generation. So in 69, the first computer art exhibition was established. It was really early when Herbert W. Franke started. And these three pieces, they're called Farbraster. For example, he worked with a Röntgenapparat too. And this apparat was could work with color already. And so, for example, these pieces, which are also based on chance, are the earliest works really printed with an inkjet printer, as we nowadays have it in every household. A nice quote from him, chance can be planned, disturbance becomes a factor, and the computer is always a partner. This is a special room dedicated to a series of work, math art. He did these many, many images which are part of different series.
Das ist Logik zum Beispiel.
In 1980, he began together with Horst Helbig, a programmer, in the Institute of German Center for Aerospace, also Luft- und Raumfahrt, with this big computer there, which was in two rooms, as long as this big computer existed in this center. So for 15 years, and they created different series based on mathematical principles. These are part of the series Algebra, so different, quite simpler mathematical principles. Math art is kind of visualization of mathematical principles. Herbert W. Franke was looking for kind of a notation system like in music. For art, because what he says is that every image can be described mathematically. use this corridor to show also his publication career. And especially this publication here, you can find, for example, the article on how to find out how old the caves are, for example, or on Mars, on Mars also caves exist. So this is the current series of his science fiction publication in the publishing house P Machinery. Here you can find older publications still in Surkamp Verlag, or this really well-known book Kunst und Konstruktion, or The World of Mathematics, the publication based on the math art projects. He used to work a lot with colors, but color is not only aesthetic quality, but it also represents the dimension of the depth, so the third dimension, the space. This room is dedicated from world models to the metaverse. So Herbert W. Franke usually has a quite abstract language for his art, but not for science fiction. So in this space we also find how science fiction, so the imagination of fantastic worlds, reappears in his body of work. Like here we have mathematically constructed architecture-like objects in landscape. Or what you can see here, this is kind of a tour through the metaverse, which is an exhibition platform he established on the internet platform Active Worlds, already starting 2005, so very early and kind of a preform for nowadays metaverse. So these are the fantastic worlds and the set gallery, which is the title of this exhibition platform. World models, what we can see here is a program. As soon as the PCs were established, the personal smaller computers, he used them to prepare his big works like in math art. But soon he established his own programs on his PC, and he was very much interested in world models. So what he did is to write programs to understand also how chance in our universe works. And what he found out is that, for example, in these world models, you have to set, like in a scientific experiment, you have to make settings. And the more chance is in, the more stable the program runs, which is also kind of a philosophy or a philosophic equivalent on how also our world works. Albert Einstein, of course, he was an important physicist, and what you can see in this example is how he generated computer graphics, because when Ars Electronica was started, it was kind of a platform for computer graphics, but for Herbert W. Franke, he was never interested in the two-dimensional image. As you can see here, he took images out of a process. And the video was already, or the program was already connected to music. This deer installation, he tried out already in 1973 by overlapping images connected with sound, how he can manage to work with a moving image. So here we have an homage to Edward Muybridge, so the one photographer who worked with images of movement. And what he did is a kind of a performance work. Here we can see the reenactment with a screen and with a dancer and with different phases of interactions. So right now we see the one person acting, but now you can see already with video programming tools how the movements of the dancer were also moved into space and to this kind of projected image. In the main hall of the Francisco Carolinum, we show a lecture Herbert W. Franke did 2008, and he talks about the development of his 65 years of algorithmic art. So he's a really good storyteller and a mediator. He used to teach in München for more than 20 years. Yeah, and the exhibition, The Visionary, Herbert W. Franke, is running till the 12th of June.